Okay guys, I'm here today with an update on the slash two-wheel drive race build, also known as the slash two-wheel drive ultimate. This is my rendition of what I believe tractors should do to get their name back into racing. I was able to pull some parts together from other trucks and just parts I had lying around to finish this build. To start with, starting from the front this time, I have the trackless shaped front bumper. Not an upgrade, but does give it a different look and helps keep the weight down. Moving on from there, I have the Team Associated RTR shocks off of a SE10 GT. My SE10 GTE I am no longer using, so I was able to take the shocks off the front and the rear. Note that the rear shock springs are way too light. This thing will not hold itself up, it just squats to the ground. So I will be replacing those before I go to the track. Next thing up front is the STRC aluminum shock tower. I have them front and rear in blue aluminum. These are to tighten up the suspension and the overall handling characteristics of the truck. The stock plastic ones move around and flex quite a bit, where these ones have no flex whatsoever in them. So definitely improvement over the stock tracks there. As moving on from there, just a little thing I added for looks is the Team Associated Factory Team twist on battery strap nut. It comes in a pack of two, but being trackless, I only needed one. From there, I have my Hobby People 35C 5000 milliamp 2S LiPo, which pretty much standard in all my cars. Moving on from the battery to the ESC, I have a Castle Creations Mamba Max Pro Short Course Truck Edition. That is a censored ESC. The BEC is mounted up top. Not sure the brand on that one. I'm pretty sure it's just the Castle though. One thing I forgot to mention is the servo. It is a high-tech Metal Gear servo. And I do believe it is on its last legs. It is not sounding so hot, guys. One other thing is the TLR Losi Racing aluminum servo horn you can see there. It's kind of the olive color, I guess they would call it. From there, I have the SR201 Spectrum receiver. That thing is completely filled. So if you want to run anything else off of this truck, you will need a bigger receiver. So say I wanted to run a fan for the motor or a glitch buster, say I got a bigger ESC, I would need a bigger receiver. So I may have to throw in my SR401 from my T4 if I end up needing it. From there, I'll move on once again, Team Associated shocks, STRC shock tower. Oh, one thing I did forget to mention, ProLine adjustable body mounts with the twist on caps. These are I'm really liking them for now anyways. I have never tried them myself. They have a nice little locking nut right there to hold the body on. No more little body clips. The main reason I like them is that their small footprint causes you have to drill smaller holes, meaning you're going to have less body cracks as you are just beating on it from flips and cartwheels and what is bound to happen to your short course truck throughout its lifetime. From there, I have the Hot Racing's aluminum carbon gearbox, carbon fiber construction, with aluminum motor plate and heat fins to disperse some of that heat from a little better. The motor that will be causing that heat is the Tekin 8.5 Gen 1 sealed can censored brushless motor. That's a little bit of a mouthful, but that is going to be powering this particular truck, and that is hooked up to my Castle Creations ESC, or will be after I do some soldering. From there, I have the shaved rear bumper as well. And am I forgetting? Yes, I am. J Concepts Barcodes Gold Compound on J Concepts Hazard Dish Wheels. The dish is optional. I did decide to go for them, front and rear. I personally like them. I think dishes look good always on a two-wheel drive. Four-wheel drive, I like just the non-dish, more the spoke style, but that's me. Also in the front, I have STRC aluminum steering knuckles as well as the caster blocks to kind of just help tighten up the steering a little more and give it a little more rigidity. Besides that, there's only a few things I need to do, which is springs, and I should be on the road. Obviously a body, but for now I have modified my SC10 GT body to work with this truck, although it ends about there and the bumper sticks out completely, which it does look kind of ridiculous, but it will work for now until I can get the body that I need. So, guys, that's it for the build series on this truck. There shouldn't be any more updates on this video or on this truck. It will only be upgrade videos from here on out. So, guys, thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and it really helps me out if you share this video. If you have any questions on this truck or any of my other trucks, leave it down in the comments below. I'm always happy to answer all your guys' comments. So, guys, thanks for watching.